Hello. So today we had our visit with the doctor, and things were made pretty official that I have three functional movement disorders. One that causes these jerkings, one that twists my hands and my feet, and one that affects how I walk. There are no medications to treat it. It will be with me lifelong. However, he does have hope that it will he'll see a good outcome in several months to a year where he can get me as close to normal as possible. But I will have recurring bouts throughout my life, more than likely, he said. Now, the treatments are going to be through specialized physical therapists and neurotherapists that are trained in functional movement disorders. It's very hard to find them. So my neurologist is meeting with a team, and they are going to be researching where the best places are that I can go to get treatment. So he said that he's going to be looking at outpatient, but also inpatient. I do not want to do that. It would be 3 weeks away from my family to find these specialists, and I don't know where that would be. So if you could just pray that it will be close to home and it will be outpatient and my insurance will cover it, that would be great. Because here's my one and only rule, and it is not a big ask, people. If it is going to be inpatient, it better darn well be in Hawaii. You know what I'm saying? Like, Hawaii or nothing. So you can add that to your prayers too. That's my Christmas wish. So anyway, so I was crying a lot today because it just became very real, and the possibility of leaving my home to go retrain my nervous system is what I have to do. Don't even know what that means. So retraining my nervous system, I do not want to do that on an inpatient basis. I want to be in my own home. Anyway, so I'm crying, I'm feeling lonely, feeling even more lonely, feeling even more lonely. Like, the feelings are just compounding, and my mom said, "Be careful. That's when Satan loves to come in and make you feel totally alone." And I realized that's totally what I'm feeling. Begone. Because Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ never want us to feel alone. They always want us to know that they are there for us. So once I got perspective today, the tears stopped. I was able to function a little bit better. And two people came to mind: Joseph Smith and Jesus Christ. Joseph Smith knew what it was like to feel alone. There was a time where the Lord pulled away from him so that he could learn some things on his own. But Heavenly Father kept him in his line of sight. He always knew what Joseph Smith was going through. And Jesus Christ, as we're celebrating Holy Week or Easter Week, we can think about him and what he suffered. I mean, his whole life he suffered. He went through a lot in order to do the Father's work. And when he was on the cross, the Father had to pull away. He had to do it on his own. And he felt alone. But he was never out of Heavenly Father's sight. Heavenly Father always was aware of what Jesus Christ was going through. So it's the same with us. We may feel like our prayers are hitting the ceiling, that Heavenly Father isn't hearing them because he's not responding. We're not hearing anything. But that's not true. It never hits the ceiling. It always reaches him. He always hears them. He always has us in his line of sight. He is always aware of what we are going through, always. Sometimes we have to learn things on our own. We have to gain confidence in ourselves, and maybe that means that he is just going to back up for just a minute so that we can make some decisions on our own and gain confidence. Whatever the case may be, please know that you are never alone, and the Comforter is always there. He can always bring you peace. You just have to ask sometimes. So anyway, if you need a little perspective, there it is, because I needed it big time. So if you're feeling alone, you just need to say it, big on. And remember who cares about you and loves you and who is always watching over you. It's Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ. They know you by name. They know you very, very well. You're their children. And he's our eldest brother, Jesus Christ is, and Heavenly Father is the Father of our spirits. He knows us very well. If you have any questions, or you want to just chat about your purpose here on earth, or you're just wondering, like, why am I here? What am I supposed to be doing? Where am I supposed to be going? What are my goals here on earth? I'd love to talk to you, because I love talking about spiritual things. So Anyway, that's it, and we will talk more later.